So we have this right angle triangle here with a right angle at B. Now let's observe what happens if we keep on decreasing this side CB. So as we keep on decreasing this side CB, we see that angle A also decreases and AC becomes almost equal to AB. So as we keep on decreasing CB, angle A decreases and AC becomes almost equal to AB. So you see angle A decreasing. Or we can say that when angle A becomes almost equal to zero, that is, we decrease angle A such that it becomes very close to zero, then what happens? The side CB becomes almost equal to zero. So CB becomes almost equal to zero, and also AC becomes almost the same as AB. So three things are happening here. One is that angle A becomes almost equal to zero. It decreases and decreases and becomes very close to zero. Second thing is AC becomes equal to AB, almost the same as AB. Not exactly the same, but almost the same as AB. And third thing is CB also becomes almost equal to zero. That is very close to zero. Now, if we consider angle A, then what will be the value of sine A and cos A? Let's see. This side is the opposite side. This side is the hypotenuse. And this is the adjacent side. So sine A, remember so, ka, toa. So from so, sine is equal to opposite by hypotenuse. So opposite by hypotenuse, that is AC. And cos A, so ka, cos is equal to adjacent by hypotenuse. So adjacent is AB and hypotenuse is AC. So sin A is CB by AC and cos A is AB by AC. Now let us consider this case when my angle A is very close to zero. So I can write this as sin 0 degree. Now sin 0 degree is equal to CB by AC. But when my angle A is almost equal to zero, then CB also becomes almost equal to zero. So I can write this as 0 by AC. 0 by anything is 0. So this is equal to 0. So we can say that sine of 0 degree is equal to 0. Also, cos 0 degree is equal to AB by AC. But when angle A becomes very close to 0 degree, then AC becomes almost the same as AB. So AC becomes almost the same as AB. So these two are almost equal. So I can write cos 0 degree is equal to 1. So we have sin 0 degree equal to 0 and cos 0 degree equal to 1. So just like we have found the trigonometric ratio for special angles 30 degree, 60 degree, 45 degree, we can find the trigonometric ratio for 0 degree as well. Sin 0 degree is 0 and cos 0 degree is 1. Now using these two trigonometric ratios, we can find the other trigonometric ratios. How? We know that tan theta is the ratio of sin theta and cos theta. So tan 0 degree is equal to sin 0 degree divided by cos 0 degree. Now sine 0 degree is 0 and cos 0 degree is 1 and 0 by 1 is 0. So we can write tan 0 degree is 0. Now cosec is the reciprocal of sine. So cosec 0 degree will be the reciprocal of sine 0 degree. That is 1 upon 0, because 0 can be written as 0 by 1. The reciprocal of 0 by 1 is 1 upon 0. And anything divided by 0 is not defined. So cosec 0 degree is not defined. Now sec 0 degree, it is the reciprocal of cos 0 degree. The reciprocal of 1 is 1. So sec 0 degree is equal to 1. Cot is the reciprocal of tan. So cot 0 degree is the reciprocal of 0. Again, as we have seen, the reciprocal of 0 is not defined. So cot 0 degree is not defined. So these are the trigonometric ratios for 0 degree. That is, these are the values of sine, cos, tan, cosec, sec and cot when the angle is 0 degree. So no matter how big or how small the triangle is, if the angle is 0 degree, then these will be the values of the corresponding trigonometric ratios. Now consider this right angle triangle. This is right angled at angle B. Let's see what happens if we keep on decreasing this side AB. So as I keep on decreasing this side AB, we see that angle A increases and it reaches very close to 90 degree. So as AB decreases, angle A increases and it becomes almost equal to 90 degree. Another thing which is happening here is CA becomes almost equal to CB. So as AB decreases, CA becomes almost equal to CB. So what we can say is that when angle A becomes very close to 90 degree, so we see that over here angle A increases and finally it becomes very close to 90 degree. So as angle A becomes very close to 90 degree, AB becomes almost equal to 0 because side AB keeps on decreasing. So AB becomes almost equal to 0 and AC becomes almost the same as CB. So we see that finally AC goes on to merge with CB. That is, it becomes almost the same as CB. So three things are happening here. Firstly, angle A becomes very close to 90 degree. Secondly, as angle A becomes very close to 90 degree, AC becomes almost the same as CB. So it is almost equal to CB. And thirdly, AB becomes almost equal to 0. That is, it vanishes. It becomes almost equal to 0. Now, if we consider angle A here, this side is the opposite side of angle A. That is, CB is the opposite side. AC is the hypotenuse. And AB is the adjacent side. So if we find sine A, sine of an angle is equal to opposite by hypotenuse. So opposite by hypotenuse, that is CB by AC, AC is the hypotenuse, and cos A is equal to adjacent by hypotenuse. Adjacent is AB here. And hypotenuse is AC. So cos A is AB by AC. So this is what we have. Sin A is CB by AC. Cos A is AB by AC. Now, since my angle A becomes very close to 90 degree, I can write sin A as sin 90 degree. Now, when A becomes very close to 90 degree, then AC becomes almost the same as CB. So, AC becomes almost the same as CB. So, these two become equal. So, I can say that sin of 90 degree is equal to 1. Similarly, when angle A becomes very close to 90 degree, then I can write cos A as cos 90 degree and AB becomes almost equal to 0. So, I can write this as 0 by AC and 0 by AC is 0. So, we can say that sin of 90 degree is equal to 1 and cos of 90 degree is equal to 0. So, these are the two trigonometric ratios for the angle 90 degree. Sin 90 degree is 1 and cos 90 degree is 0. So, just like we have found the trigonometric ratios for special angles 30 degree, 60 degree, 45 degree, we can find the trigonometric ratios for 90 degree using these values of sin and cos. So, let's do that. So, we have sin 90 degree is equal to 1 and cos 90 degree is equal to 0. Now, tan of an angle is the ratio of sine of that angle to cos of that angle. So, I can write tan 90 degree is equal to sin 90 degree divided by cos 90 degree. Sin 90 degree is 1 and cos 90 degree is 0. 1 divided by 0. Now, any number divided by 0 is not defined. So, tan of 90 degree is actually not defined. What about cosec 90 degree? Cosec 90 degree is the reciprocal of sin 90 degree. Now, sin 90 degree is 1. It can be written as 1 by 1. The reciprocal of 1 by 1 will be 1 by 1, which is equal to 1. So, cosec 90 degree is 1. Sec 90 degree. It is the reciprocal of cos 90 degree. Now, cos 90 degree is 0. It can be considered as 0 by 1. Now, the reciprocal of 0 by 1 is 1 by 0. And 1 by 0 is not defined. So, sec 90 degree is not defined. Now, what about cot 90 degree? Again, cot is the reciprocal of tan. But we see that tan is not defined. So, how do we find cot 90 degree? Now, recall that cot of an angle is the ratio of cos of that angle to sin of that angle. So, I can find cot 90 degree as cos 90 degree divided by sin 90 degree. Now, cos 90 degree is 0 and sin 90 degree is 1. 0 by 1 is equal to 0. So, cot 90 degree is equal to 0. So, these are the trigonometric ratios for 90 degree. So, whenever the angle is 90 degree, these will be the corresponding values of the different trigonometric ratios sin, cos, tan, no matter how big or how small the triangle is. So, we have studied the trigonometric ratios corresponding to the angle 0 degree and 90 degree, and you need to remember them.